Thank you, seniors. Forever go blue. Ah! Thank you, seniors, and forever go blue.
Thank you, seniors, and forever go blue.
Thank you, seniors, and forever go blue.
Respect.
Thank you, seniors, forever go blue.
Thank you, seniors, forever go blue.
My face above the water. My feet can't touch the ground. Touch the ground and it feels like I can see the sand.
Ben Manco is hilarious. He pulls out jokes from nowhere, which will make the whole team cry.
His sarcasm and his witty humor just gets me.
Is being really sarcastic, so he'll always chime in as like a third party, like out of nowhere, and just make like a sarcastic comment.
Something I miss about Ben is his sarcastic humor. No matter what you say, at any given point, if he's feeling up or down, he'll always be sarcastic.
There's little sly jokes,
little sarcastic comments that he makes. He's creative in what he says. Like he says some random things sometimes, but people catch on to it and think it's hilarious, and I think it's hilarious.
I laugh at all of his jokes.
He's always encouraging people from the sidelines. He's, you know, offering to talk to young guys, all these different things, and I think that's something that I really admire about him, and I think it's something that he should be proud of, along with, you know, his family and the rest of the university here.
Even though he doesn't get the playing time that sometimes he might deserve, he still continues to work hard day in, day out. He doesn't complain, he doesn't mope around. Even as a fifth-year senior, he's still, you know, picking up some of the bibs or the cones and stuff, picking up water bottles, and to see that from a fifth-year senior just goes to show that he plays for Michigan, and that's something that's greater than himself.
And just the way he practices and the way he trains, and when he does get in games, he's always ready. And
he always puts the team first before himself.
Ben is just one of those guys that you can define as a Michigan man.
I think Manco, you know, brings the team that definition of a Michigan man. You know, he's always about the team.
He encompasses all the different aspects that make up the Michigan man.
His legacy will probably be known as the most sarcastic kid to ever play in this program. Kid just does not stop joking.
I want to wish you the best of luck in the future. Thank you for being someone I can look up to.
Manco, I'd like to thank you for what you helped me accomplish in my time here at Michigan. I know I've probably never spoken to you about it, but you've definitely helped me with my journey to Ross.
I just want to say good luck, Ben, everything you do. I know you've done fantastic on the field here and off the field, and I know there's, you know, a great future ahead of you, and goes
really. Really respect everything you've done, the way you represent yourself in this university, and you know, you're a great guy and you're gonna do great things, so thank you, Ben.
I hope everything goes well after you graduate, and I hope to stay in touch with you because you're really someone that I value my friendship with.
One of the pillars of this team is blue collar quality, and I think that's Lewin, like that describes him in the best way.
Nick, I think, is the ideal blue-collar type of player. He's extremely hardworking, very humble.
Nick will leave behind a legacy of hard work.
You know, he's someone you always want to go to battle with in games and stuff, because you know that he's practiced the right way, and therefore, when it comes to the game, he's gonna deliver for you.
I will miss Nick's Americanness. I'll miss him coming in with his Detroit Tigers hat on, big brown boots with some Wrangler jeans.
He's just such a nice kid and very friendly, and very easily get along with, very fun on and off the field. Have a lot of memories with him.
Me and my roommate Nate.
Me and my roommate Ahinga.
we missed all of our alarms. It was 7:10 and we were supposed to depart to go to the airport at 7:30.
I remember waking up at like 7:10.
We're trying to call everyone, trying to find a ride, trying to find a taxi. Nobody would come through. Buses weren't working that day.
And we get a call from Nick.
Luan says, I'm coming.
I'll be there in 2 minutes. You better be ready.
It's our savior. He's just God for that moment. That's a huge story that I always remember about Luan.
One memory that I have with Luan would probably be Mario Tennis at Tyler Arnone's house. That's always been a great time with Luan. Luan's very competitive and we get heated, but at the end of the day, we're still good friends. So.
He will be remembered just being a guy who just gives his all on the field.
The kid just pushed me in the weight room and also on the field this year. He's been playing right back, right behind me a lot, and he always does his job, which is something just great about him and I've always admired.
Just conducts himself, you know, in a top class manner all the time, and that's something I have a lot of respect for.
Three words that I would use to describe Luan would be intelligent, hardworking, and relentless.
I'd say Nick is humble, hardworking, and most importantly, hard body.
Nick Luan is intelligent, hardworking, and blue collar.
Nick, I just want to wish you the best in anything that you pursue after college. I know that whether it's in school or in soccer, you'll be successful because of your attitude and your work ethic.
One thing that I always remember, Mark was always wears the tightest jeans.
Kid can't really speak Spanish, but I'll let him off with that one.
He's taught me how to take care of the body, always stretching and doing what he has to do to practice.
His roller and strap techniques.
He is fully naked, foam rolling.
2 minutes later, and he's stretching, leg spread on the floor. I don't know, that's just Coach, that's just Marcos. So, something that I'll always remember.
He takes care of his body 24/7. You can catch him after practice, 20 minutes after practice, 20 minutes before practice, rolling and strapping, just getting his body ready for the next day.
He walks over to me and I thinking he was just gonna be like, Tristan, like I hope you get better soon. He comes up to me, puts his hand on my head, without saying anything, takes my head and gives it a little kiss and just walks away. And I just thought it was the funniest thing. And that's just hashtag coast being coast.
I'll miss foam rolling in the locker room.
Something I'll miss about Marcos is taking the ice baths with him after every single practice.
I will miss the ice baths when everybody's left the locker room.
He's also, you know, left a legacy of being a fantastic football player with a lot of abilities.
What he brought to the table was that he was so professional in the way he went about playing and training.
Professionalism and passion for the game.
Marcos's legacy is that he was a perfectionist on and off the field. I think he really brought a professional attitude to training.
Marcos has always been that guy that I can always go talk to. He's always given me some kind of advice, always trying to keep me up during the game or just let me know like one little thing I'm doing wrong, what I can work on. And I really, really appreciate that because it's helped me out so much and I'll always be thankful for that.
You were by far one of my closest friends just because how you were there for me from day one.
Had some great times with you, been a great mate, and we'll obviously stay in contact after you leave school. And I know you're going to go on to do big things and have a big career, so go Blue and good luck.
He always has a smile on his face and he's always, you know, positive in everything that he does.
You know, he brought good work ethic and a smile to every practice.
Grinny is the definition of a leader. He's down to earth. He's the nicest guy you'll ever meet.
He's really impacted me and helped me in the process of becoming a Michigan man.
I think Adam's one of the best goalkeepers that I'll ever come through this program. You know, you rarely feel like you're going to get scored on with Adam in the back, and it's just that utmost confidence in him, and he can make every save, and just bringing that to the table every single game is
unlocked. The legacy that Adam is going to leave behind is massive, because he's, in my opinion, one of the best players that will ever come through this program, and one of the best keepers I've ever played with.
I think his legacy will be that he's probably been the best goalkeeper this program's ever seen. So.
He always held everybody in the goalkeeping court to the highest level every day.
I think I'm gonna miss, honestly, like him breaking it down each and every day and staying positive, you know, just huddling everybody up, getting everybody rallied in the 6 a.m. list, always screaming, getting everyone hype. I think I'm gonna miss that. And obviously his like comforting personality, just being there for me, being there to talk to me when I'm down.
I'll miss Adam bringing it in for after the every game, practice, lift, whatever it is. He's always at the breakdown going, so it's gonna be weird to see someone else leading it.
Oh, Adam, he loves breaking down everything. Like, we could have just stretch for a second, he breaks it down, then we go back, and you know, we're foaming for all the games. Like, wait, let's break it down again. Like, I don't like that. Like, let's do it again.
And he was always that guy to bring us together, and I think bringing us together for the Let's Go Blue was symbolic as how he brought us together as a team.
I remember one time we were in training, and he made a save and turned around, looked at me dead in the face, and he was convinced he broke his butt.
Off season in the winter, and we came in for 8:30, I think, practice in the morning, and it was just straight fitness that day. It was terrible. Then Adam, before practice, we were together and we were watching the rowers doing their planks, and then we would always mimic what they were saying. I would be like, come on, and I think that'll be by far the best memory, just repeating that over and over. Definitely the best memory.
Rennie, I really am rooting for you, brother, that you go pro. I want to see you in the MLS or wherever you go, man. I really want to see you do well, because I love you, kid. I really grew a bond with you on the field and off the field, and I really want you to do well.
Rennie, you're the man. Hope we stay friends forever.
Thank you, Adam, for having a huge impact on this team, being so positive all the time, and I hope that you're able to continue playing soccer and do what you love to do.
I'm gonna miss you. You've been extremely influential in my goalkeeping career, and you've become, you know, not only a really close friend, but like an older brother to me, and you've taught me so much, and I just wanna wish you the best of luck in all your endeavors in the future.
Tyler Unknown. What can I say about Tyler Unknown?
TA is one of the pillars of the program.
When he leaves this university, he will definitely be regarded as one of the best players, if not the best player to have ever played for this university.
Even though he may come across as a hard nut, he is emotional. He does have emotion. I have seen it. So yeah, he's definitely a great guy to be around, and I wish him all the best, hopefully in the draft. And
Tyler is always fighting to win everything. It's something that, it sounds simple as an athlete, but it's really not, because he'll go the extra mile to win a game or do well in school.
Tyler Unknown, he is a leader.
Just the leader on the team that I look up to. Someone who you can always look to, whether it's on the field when we're losing in a game, someone to lead us out of that, or whether you're having problems off the field, someone to talk to about that.
He always puts the team before himself.
Honestly, he just made my whole experience just awesome.
Always one of the most competitive guys, and you know, sometimes you hate Tyler on the field because he just nips and he's a cheat sometimes, and you know, he knows it, and but he just does it to win, and that's why we love having him on our team in the games, because he's a winner.
He's gonna work his ass off, and he deserves every minute that he gets, and that has impacted the team just to work. And he's one of those guys who will always give 110%, and I think that helps be reciprocated throughout the whole entire team.
Lewin and I are next to him, and you know, he's always just like, what's your weight? What's your weight, Maka? Like, what's your weight? Move up. Or he's just doing push-ups in between sets when it's not even on there. It's not even on the workout. And the guy is just East Coast. I mean, the guy's a legend. And
just playing like every game is really his last on this earth. And the love, like, you know that this guy has love for us, and you can see it in his emotions and how he feels about this whole program. You can tell that this guy has love for every single one of his players, and that's a legacy I think he lives on.
Three words to describe Tyler: intense, leader, and technical.
He pushes everybody, so he gets the best out of everybody.
And making everybody else better, coming into training every single day and having super high expectations for everybody else to be better and as a group play good football.
His competitiveness in every training session that he brings and just trying to make everyone else better and also himself.
He's just someone that we always look to set the standard and how hard we're going to go in practice, or he always sets the tone for how competitive things are going to be.
This year, we were doing a 6v6 tournament, round robin. Second game, we got blew out, I think it was 5-0, and TA was tripping, absolutely going off, this is disgraceful, blah, 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 and we ended up winning the whole tournament and training. And it's an example that he always expects the best out of everybody.
He's always busting his ass off season, during season, weight room, doesn't matter when, and everybody sees that. What am I not gonna miss? Just him in the locker room, you know, seeing his face. He's got a great smile.
You know, the little salsa dance, it's funny.
Great guy to be around, really, really fun. Fun-loving guy. There's nothing specific that I'm gonna miss about him, just everything. It's kinda gonna suck next year without TA, to be honest.
Your legacy here is just a credit to the kind of person you are. And you know, I really respect and admire that, and just wanted to wish you the best of luck with everything with TA.
Thank you, seniors, and forever go blue.
Me go.